Don't force. If you need to stretch the legs, stretch it and come back. Yeah, until it feels more comfortable, more natural. Yeah. And just start to settle there. And the first thing that we will do is push a little bit with your hips into the floor. And try to lift in your chest a tiny bit, not too hard that you tense the whole body. So softly press with your hips and notice that pulling up of your spine and your chest up. And then try to soften your arms, yeah, your shoulders, hands on the legs or on the floor. And from this position, I start to focus on or the sensation of your body or your breathing, whatever is more easy for you. Yeah? So, or you focus on your breathing or on the sensation of your hips on the floor, or if you find difficult to cut out the exterior, what's going on outside your room, you can place your hands on your belly and in your heart, and just notice the movement of the breath in your body. Okay? Good. And focus for a few breaths on the breathe out part. Okay? And as you breathe out, imagine that we start to release our roots, as always, yeah? Those roots from your body into the floor, into the planet. Or you can always use the visualization of the mat already set up with your roots, and you only need to plug yourself on those roots. And as you focus on the breathe out, imagine those roots expanding more, yeah, creating a huge base for your support. And really imagine going deeply with the roots into the very core, the very heart of the planet, so we can start to receive that pure and touch energy. So when you have that in mind, you can start to focus on the breathing as well. And imagine when you breathe in, you're receiving that beautiful energy that goes into your body, into your mind, into your heart, starting to move around to help you to release the tension and the stress, yeah? The physical tension and the stress, the emotional tension. So you breathe in, you receive that energy. When you breathe out, you release all that tension and the stress also on the roots. And the roots will take it for you. And imagine that the roots will act as a recycle center. So you can receive your own energy again, nice and fresh and pure, plus all the nutrients of the planet. Yeah? So you receive an enhanced energy to nurture yourself, yeah, to recharge. Yeah? So with all this in mind, we can put the hands in front of you on the floor, but not forcing. So when you lean forward, remember to keep your chest up. Yeah? So you lean like with your belly. Don't go directly with the head. Yeah? So you keep pushing into the hips and you open your chest and you lean forward, wherever is okay, don't force. Then you can relax the head, yeah? After you lean with the belly first. Now remember not to push too much here. Remember in the morning, we are more cold than in the evening, yeah? So give that extra care to your body. We move the hands to one side. And we go to the other side. And then coming back to the center, we put the hands behind, pushing into the hips again, roll the shoulders, yeah? Roll the shoulders back. You want the chest nice and open. And this, you can do it sitting while you are working on your desk, yeah? Roll your shoulders, you can catch the chair behind as you are sitting, and do this little opening or big opening here, yeah, to help your body to keep open during your day. Good. And then relax. We change, we put the other leg. Again, you can open the legs as much as you need. Again, that little push into the hips. Roll the shoulders, start to go with your belly toward your feet, and then surrender. And in this position, imagine that you are letting go all the tension and the stress. Move the hands to one side. And we go to the other side. And then to the center, coming back. We put the hands pushing into the hips, shoulders away, open. And spread. And in this one, imagine that you're absorbing. So every time that we open the body, imagine that you're absorbing the energy from the planet. Yeah, you are recharging. And also imagine that it's so much beautiful energy that you receive that is overflowing yourself and form or enhance that cocoon that we always work here, yeah? That cocoon around you. So imagine that you put extra energy there. So you have it for your week. And then relax, yeah? And we will move a little bit here like a circle. And again, imagine that you are increasing that connection, that routine with the planet, so you can keep absorbing more energy, yeah? And in the physical level, we are working on inner thighs, hips, lower back. We go to the other side. Softly. Well done. Now on the center, pushing into the hips, roll the shoulders, and we'll start to a twist. Bring your belly a tiny bit in, not too much that you can breathe, yeah, a little bit, and start to rotate. You hips and you lifting up with the crown of your head. As you move back, relax your shoulders, yeah? So always that rolling back of the shoulders to position your soft, gentle way. Try to keep the position of the hips equally grounding on the floor, yeah? Don't go into one hip or the other. Then we keep the position, we bring the head only to the front and to the other side. And then back to the twist. And relax. Pushing again into the center, roll the shoulders, belly a tiny bit in, and we move to the other side. Roll the shoulders, yeah? Expand open, and then we move the head to the front and to the other side. And then back to the twist. Relax, well done. We go to all fours, yeah? So hands and knees on the floor. If you need a support for your knees, you can always put the blanket beneath, yeah? And hands nice and open, fingers open, yeah? To help also on the joints of the fingers. And we move the hips in circles. Roll the shoulders, yeah? When you go forward, breathe in. When you go back, breathe out. Softly. And then the opposite direction. And then on the center, breathe in and open, arching shoulders away. So nice and open your spine here, head up, bum out, but without forcing, without tensing. And then rounding, bring the chin toward the chest, relax your shoulders, and breathe in open. You do it in your own rhythm. And breathe out, rounding. So gentle, but try to open to the maximum that you can do in this moment. Soft, yeah, always caring with your body. Now we will curve the toes. We put the back of the toes on the floor. Spread the back of the toaster, arching again, expanding, breathing, rounding, squeeze your toes. Go, breathing, open, arching. Breathe out, squeezing and rounding. One more time. And if you can, try to squeeze your belly when you round, yeah, to activate a little bit your core more. And we are working at the same time on your pelvic floor. Yeah? Squeeze. Good. Well. And we open the knees and we go to child pose. Relaxing back. Soften. So move your bum as much back as you can. And then relax your belly and your chest and then your head. We always start from the hips. Yeah, don't rely directly on your head. First on the hip, then belly, then chest, then head. Relax your shoulder blades. Soften. If it's uncomfortable, you can always put your hands beneath your forehead. Yeah? We move the hands to one side. And we go to the other side. And then coming back to the center. We go to all fours and we will bring one arm beneath the other arm. Yeah? Putting the shoulder first, then the head. Take a moment here to expand your neck without forcing and then your arm on the front. Relaxing, yeah? So allow your chest to soften toward the floor, toward the arm that is beneath you. Using your breath out. Surrender, falling into the position, not forcing. Good. Change, we go to the other side. Shoulder, then expand the neck, position the arm, and start to relax on the breath out with your chest. Good, and then coming back. Well done. Now we will come back one more time to child pose. And we will put one arm on the front. Doesn't need to be too close to the head, comfortable. And we will put the other arm right on cross position. And we relax in that position. It's soft. We are not forcing the opening here, just relax. Going with your hips back, yeah? Relaxing your belly and your chest toward the floor. The head could be a little bit up, or with your forehead on the floor. Depending, I find it that that's depending on the nose that you have, yeah? If you have a big nose as me, the forehead is really difficult to put it on the floor, yeah? Good, and then we change. We put the other arm on the front, and the other arm on the side, and relax. Soften. Not forcing, soften into the breath. Relax, well done. We will go to all fours, we will start with the legs, shoulders away again. We bring one leg back, the back here, opening, arching, but not in a forcing way, and then rounding. When you round, again, you bring your belly a tiny bit in. Breathing open, breathe out, round. Yeah, the knee toward the head, squeeze your belly a little bit. Breathing open, shoulders away, rounding, rounding, rounding. We want to move the spine as well, yeah, just to bring more flexibility, more opening, and to release the tension that we have. We will go back, and now we will bend the leg. We will cross over the other leg. Yeah? We'll expand back and we go forward rounding. Yeah. So breathing back, breathe out cross, breathing back, breathe out rounding. Breathing back, breathe out cross, breathing in, breathe out forward one more time. Expand, cross, round, expand, forward, rounding. Well done. We go with the other leg. Breathing open. Now forward only first, yeah? So rounding and squeezing your belly. Breathing open, shoulders are away. Breathe out rounding, squeezing your belly. One more time, expanding. Squeeze your belly a tiny bit, yeah? And we will cross, so we go back. We cross, back, back, forward. Breathing back. Breathe out cross, breathing in, breathe out forward. One more time. Breathing in, cross, breathing up and forward. Last time. Expand, cross, expand, rounding. Well done. Now we will put one leg forward, yeah? And we will move the hip forward here. So, remember always the knee above your ankle or behind, never in front, yeah? Expand shoulders, spread, open, yeah? And we're lifting the arms here. Softening the hips, yeah? Good. Expand. Check that your arms are not tensing up. What we will do now, we will put the hands on the side of the mat, yeah? So your foot is here, you put the hands here, yeah? And we will move the foot to the side, yeah? And we will increase the opening of the hip forward, yeah? So the front leg will look like this, yeah? Chest is open. Yeah, so check, you can open here the hip, but we are not forcing, okay? So we go with the hands first. You move the hip forward. So this leg, the groin is toward the front and the floor, yeah? Now, if you are super flexible and you are right with the elbows, go for it, yeah? But if not, stay nice and easy there. With the shoulders back, check that you are not tensing your shoulder. If you are with the elbows, check again that you are not tensing your shoulder. Don't squeeze your shoulders up. Yeah, well done. Now coming back, bring the foot to the center and we will ground the heel and we will go back, 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 back. We don't extend this knee to the maximum, always soft. Bum is out. We can put both hands on the floor or one hand on the leg and the other one on the floor. Yeah. So the stretch, you want to feel it on the thighs, not on the lower back. If you feel it here, it's because you are rounding. So bum out, chest open, you go back. Yeah, we go forward, we change, we move the other leg. So we move forward, 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 forward. Check the knee. You have to see your toes. If you don't see the toes, it's because your knee is too far forward. Yeah, so check that you see your toes. Relax your hips, shoulders expand, nice and big. Open chest, yeah, so we are not forcing on the lower back here, we open the chest. Very nice, we put the hands on the side of the foot, we move the foot to the side of the mat. We move the hip forward, yeah? So we keep pushing with your bone forward and we open the front knee. Roll the shoulders, open your chest, yeah? So we can stay with the hands or we can put the elbows. The shoulders, remember, you keep going away. Even if with hands or the elbows, away. Check that you are not here because you know you're stretching the hip and the shoulder, you will be more tense, yeah? Coming back, we move the heel, We go back, yeah? So again, bomb out, and we go back. Don't force the knee. So even if you are super flexible and you can bring the knee extending, don't push the kneecap there. No, out, and again. Check that you feel the stretch on the thighs, not on the lower back. If you notice on the lower back, open chest, bum out. Beautiful, we go forward. Yeah, and we will go all the way up, expanding. Ah, lengthen, and we soften. Yeah, so we will start from there. Yes, expand. We will stay a little bit here, stretching your sides. Again, check that you are not squeezing your shoulders. And pressing to the floor, softening the knees, we will go to the side. Remember, the side is going up and in diagonal. It's not going to the side straight, because if not, you break the line of the body, the alignment. So spread up, and you want to push into the feet, not into the knees, to expand your body. Remember that you want to absorb energy and distribute it through your body, yeah? And we go expanding to the other side. So you want that distribution to be nice and flowy. Well done. Expand one more time and release, yeah? So when we breathe in at the beginning of the sun salutation, imagine that you are lifting all that energy and goes into your body, yeah? So. Breathing, expanding, open, receiving. On the breathe out, hips out, bending your knees. We go again, belly, solar plexus, chest, head. We stay a little bit in there, relaxing your head, your arms, and your shoulders. Put your hands on your shins and look up. So the bum is out, your back is straight, your head is up. Your shoulders are away. That's the position that you want on the plank now, yeah? So we put the hands on the floor. When we go to plank, you want the shoulders away, chest lifted, head in line, heels back, yeah? The belly is in a little bit and the hips are in, knees to the floor. We will do just a one, all fours first. Breathing open, all fours, and we will go to downward facing dog. We stay in the downward facing dog. That is the first that we did today. So pushing back with your hips, the knees a little bit bending, relaxing your head, relaxing your heels. Not forcing here. So you want to bring your body back away from your hands, let's say. Bending the knees so you can move your bum more back. Imagine that you are in a child pose here, yeah? So bend the legs, go with your bum back like you are doing a child pose, standing, and open your chest. Once you feel nice and open on the chest, then you can relax your heels over the floor. Well done. Now we will move the right leg forward. We can go directly with your foot or put the knee first and then your foot. Yeah. So relax. Open the arms. Yeah. Soften. Check here again that your shoulders are not up. Relax and try to roll back again and then expand. Yeah, so you don't want this or this. You roll the shoulders and expand, yeah? And at the same time, we relax the hips. Yeah, we soften, remember the front knee, open, yeah? Not going to the center because that closed your hip and put all the alignment went to the window. Yeah, so relax, we put the arm on the leg. Roll the shoulders, open hip, belly, chest. We lift in the arm. Again, shoulders. Sorry I sound a broken record, but it's the only way that we bring awareness and you release the pain. Relax the hips, yeah? So with the arm in this position, softly we move forward without tensing, yeah? And we feel from the heel to the hand, pushing into the front leg, belly strong, we open. And relax the hip, bringing the knee up to the side. Yeah? Remember, not close your knee or your hip. Coming back, soften again, rotate, belly strong, hands on the floor, plank. Shoulders away, open your chest. Knees on the floor. We can keep going to all fours, or we can go slowly to cobra, belly in, shoulders away, or upward facing dog, shoulders away. We go back, hips. Up and back, your knees soft. And then you relax your heels, relax your head. We bring the left leg forward. We go again to warrior two. Good. Very nice. So soften. Remember the knee. Remember the arms. Roll back and expand. Chuck, chuck, chuck. Yeah? But not tensing. Soften. Relax your hip. Arm on the leg. We ground. We open. We want all this nice and open. Shoulders back, chest open. We lift in the arm in this position, wherever is comfy. Don't tense. Yeah? Doesn't need to be up here. Even can be here on the front, and then you open your chest. Yeah? Cool. We move the arm forward without tensing. You push into the heel to receive that energy through your body, through the side. And then we push it into this leg, so we receive in this side. Yeah? It's like with your grounding and your pushing, you are directing, you are commanding the energy of the planet to feel yourself. Yeah? Cool. So bending again, rotate back. Yeah, so feel that you are the queen of the planet. Knee, so you command. We go down, all fours, cobra, or upward facing dog. Shoulders away, belly's in, yeah? If it's too much, we keep on all fours. We go back, so hips, back, back, back. Start with the knees bending, so you can really move your hips. And then expand with your heels toward the floor. We move the legs forward. And we go all the way up, expanding, lengthen, spread, relax. We go one more time, breathing open. Breathe out, relax, soften, breathing open. Breathe out, plank, shoulders away. We go forward, chest and chin, cobra, all fours. Or upward facing dog, belly in. We go back, hips, belly, solar plexus, chest, head, heels. Right leg forward. We go to warrior two again. Set, very nice. We will go to triangle. So keep the knee open. Yeah, important, check. Then you move your thigh back. Yeah. When you move your thigh back, check that you are not tensing that knee. A little bit bending. And we move with this hand far away. So your hips are going that way, like a downward facing dog. The hip is going that way, the arm here. Check when you go that your hips are not out. They are in line with your body. So not away, in line. Yeah? And then we put the arm on the leg, thigh, knee. We open, we do the same like we did on the warrior two. We expand, yeah? So shoulders away. So we will flow from warrior two. We go back, we expand. Coming back, warrior two, move the hips out. Out, I mean back, yeah? And then forward, hand on the leg, expanding open, spread. One more time, bending, relax your hips, open the front. We are not touching the lower back, we open the front. Coming back, Move back. Spread. Triangle. Open. Expand. Bending the front leg. We go to warrior two. We rotate back to plank. Shoulders away. And we go chest and chin. Cobra or upward facing dog or all fours. If you are here, remember you are on your hands, not behind. It's not like the downward facing dog. You always here on your hands. We go back. Now we go back with the downward facing dog. Far away. We bring the left leg forward. Warrior two. Go. Expand. Yeah. Knee front. This is really important. This out, hip in. Yeah. Check. Check. To keep the alignment. Well done. We go back. Push. The hip is going following direction of this line. And we go forward. We put the hand wherever falls. And then we open. Remember when we do this, you want to be in line, not breaking in different lines. One line only. Yeah? Good. Now, we bend the front leg, relax your hips, hand on the leg, expand up, but the hips are going down. We go forward, we press back, we go forward, triangle. Take your time, expand, shoulders away. Bending the front leg, we put the hand behind, open, spread. Coming back, we go back. We go forward, last time. Oh, bending the front leg, we open and expand. Very nice. Coming back, we settle and we go back to plank, shoulders away, and we go chest and chin, shoulders away, belly in, and we go back, open back. And then relax. We bring the legs forward toward the hands. And we go all the way up, expanding and open. Relax. Well done. Very nice. Now we will open the knees, the legs. Sorry, this is a new one and it's all, it keeps falling. Good. So we open the legs. So check, don't change your device. If you are with a mat like this, just open the legs outside the mat so you don't have to move too much. Yeah? So legs open, a good separation that you feel, not so close. Yeah, open. Now show you from the knees. So again, bum is out. Knees are bending, not in a squat. Soften the knees. Yeah. So we will move the hips out. We will put the hands on the thighs. Yeah. Chest is lifted, head up. So we will go with the belly toward the inner thighs. The spine is open, the head is up. Yeah? Okay? This position is really important for hips and lower back. When you feel that you are nice and back and your belly is already between your thighs, then you start to release your chest, your head and your arms. The hands could be hanging or on the floor. Bending a little bit the knees, but not in a squat, yeah? Relax your head, soften. Good, now we will look up. So breathing up, you can put the hands on the floor or on the shins. To a table pose position, breathe in, table pose, breathe out, relax down. Breathe in, chest, head up, breathe out, belly, chest, head. Again, breathing up, head and chest, breathe out, belly, chest, head. Last time, breathing up, breathe out, relax. Well done. We will put the hands again on your shins or on your knees. We lead with head and chest all the way up, expanding, opening. Very nice. We will move the feet out, the toes up, out. Yeah. We will push with the heels into the floor with the sole of your feet, the ball of your foot and your heel. And expand without going into tension with the knees. Yeah. So we go up, expanding, going to a starfish position, shoulders away. Spread. Yeah. Open, open. Try to feel that you are expanding this area, but without tensing the knees, because if not, that will tense your lower back. Knees soft. Yeah? So we open chest and groin area without hanging on the lower back. Yeah, up, up. Yeah, with the help of your feet. And then we will put the hands on the hips again. We will rotate the feet, the toes forward, like in the first pose. Bum out, we will do it one more time. Out, chest up, head. We go with the belly, 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 belly. And then relax. Yeah. We will put the hands on the floor or on the shins one more time, wherever is possible. Yeah. And we will go from there, lifting chest and head all the way up, expanding. Well done. Very nice. Last one here. We open toes again. We will go into a squat, like the fitness squat with the legs open. So low, but not tense. You don't go chak, chak, chak. Yeah? Open, open the knees. Try to soften the weight of your body there. Yeah. So the weight is back. You are not into the toes or the knees. Your knees are out. So you want a softness here, not go tensing. Yeah. Relax, relax, relax. Try to soften. Yeah. Soften, soften, soften. Yeah. And then we will push again into the feet. Push. Expand, don't tense your knees, try to expand from here and squeeze your pelvic floor here. So don't tense your knees, squeeze here, chuck, 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 squeeze your glutes, squeeze your belly, don't tense the knees. If you tense the knees, you lose the tension on the pelvic floor. So keep the knees a little bit open and squeeze. We all need a little bit of pelvic floor, yeah? Go and expand. One more time. And relax, release. Well done. We put the feet together. Good. And we will do the last one, salute, just to go to the floor. Yeah. So on the top of the mat, breathing open. Expand. Breathe out, relax. Soften. Breathing, lengthen, open. Go back to plank. Lengthen your body. Stay, shoulders away, belly in, knees on the floor, chest and chin, or all fours, or upward facing dog. And then go to your knees. Good. Now, just one correction here. Yeah, if you are doing the upward facing dog, when you lean into the floor, don't go straight up, go forward. It's like you hover in the floor, forward. Okay, I'll show you one more time. So you are with the knees on the floor. Yeah. So you go with the chest and the knees, the chest and the chin, and then you go forward to expand. Don't go from here. Yeah. Okay. And then we go back. Sorry, we're here. We go up, downward facing dog, hips back. Open, open, open. And we bring the knees to the floor. We will do a little bit of child pose. Expanding, hips back, belly between your thighs. Relax your chest, relax your forehead. And we will put the hands behind your head or your shoulder blades, moving the elbows now a little bit closer to your head. Try not to tense too much. And we go back. Good. Softening your chest toward the floor. If it's too much with the hands behind your head, you can always adopt like a prayer position to make it more easy for your shoulder blades. And relax. We will go into hero pose. So we stay on the knees. Now, you can put cushions beneath your knees or beneath your bum. If this is too much, that you are suffering the knees, go into sitting. You can sit it on the floor with the legs crossed or even in a chair. Doesn't matter, because now we will focus on the upper body. This is just to give another stretch to the thighs. Yeah. Cool. So once you choose your position, wherever you are, you push again into the hips. Yeah. Yeah. Check that you are comfy. Well done. Blanket, cushions. Perfect. Very nice. So once you are there, you push into the hips, whether it's on your toes or on the floor or on a chair. Push, open, shoulders away. We open the arms. When you open the arms, check that you are soft, not tense. Now, you stay there. Before we start, try not to bring the arms. We want this open, yeah? But instead of bringing the arms here, that will lift the shoulder and put tension, we keep the arms and we open with the chest. It's the same opening, but it's a much better position for your body. Yeah. So you keep the arms, you open with the chest, and then in your next breath out, we will round like you have a big, imagine that you want to hug your cocoon, the cocoon that always talk. Yeah? So you hug far away, and then we catch the shoulder blades, wherever you are right, or the arms, wherever you are right, doesn't matter. And shoulders, yeah, okay? So breathing open, breathe out, we push back. Breathing open, and imagine like you are hugging or yourself or the cocoon or someone that you are missing. Oh, chiqui, 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 chiqui. Yeah, good. Very nice. Well done. God, I'm thinking in my son that I, it's like a 3 months that I don't see him. Now, cross the arms, keep the position. We flip the hands up and we catch the hands if it's possible. If not, we leave it like that. And shoulders away. And we're lifting up and down the elbows. But you keep your nice posture, chest open, shoulders away. Good. Yeah. And then open again. We will go to the other side. Yeah? So again, open chest. Yeah. You are hugging this beautiful cocoon around you. You catch all this energy and we cross the other arm around. We catch your shoulder blades or your arms. Yeah. Wherever you are right. Breathing open. Breathe out, release. Yeah. So you decide there hugging energy or hugging someone that you miss. Or yourself, you're hugging yourself and saying that you love you. Yeah. God, we cross, we flip the hands, catch it there, up and down. Shoulders are relaxing as you do that movement. And always you try to bring the shoulders away. And that's the awareness that we want to create. When you are in your desk, you want always the shoulders back. So whenever you remember, boom, 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 shoulders back. Good. We release. Soften here. So soften a little bit. We move one arm up. Doesn't need to be here. Yeah. Place the hand so you can feel an opening here between your ear and your shoulder. And then you put the hand back. Now, remember when you put the hand back here, if you don't do any extra action, your shoulder be pointing forward. So you need to roll anyway. Yeah. Roll and down. You want that space. Yeah. So from there, you expand, spreading comfortable. Breathe, not tense. Breathe. The breathing will tell you if you are tensing or not. Yeah. Expand. We put this hand, we put this hand. Remember, if you don't do any action, you will tense here. So roll, check, space. And we go from there. Sorry, I have my mic. Expand, open, breathe. Well done, and then relax, soften. Put the hands on your legs, relax the shoulders. Yeah, good. We will do a little bit of movement for the head before we go to the floor. So roll the shoulders again. Chest is lifted. If you need it, you can do it sitting, yeah? And we will move the head to one side and then back to the front, back to the side, back to the front. When you do this movement at home, this is the pace, not fast. Breathing on the side, breathe out to the front, one more time, breathe into the side, and the shoulders are rolled back, yeah? Well done. Now, we will go to the floor. Before you go, when we do the bridge, we will try to work in this position first, yeah? So check that you are separating the shoulder blades. You help with the wrist, chuk, 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 and check that you are not tensing your shoulders, yeah? Spreading, good. So we will lying down on the back. Yeah? Good. And knees bending. Position your arms in cross, yeah? So we start from the belly and the lower back. You bring the hips tilting forward a tiny bit. Belly a little bit in. You want to feel the lower back deeply on the floor. And grounding that part, you start to push back and up, back. Yeah, so with your spine, trying to go longer, the chin toward the chest without lifting your head from the floor. Yeah, so you want to feel really the back of the head and the chin forward. And then with your arms, you try to spread the shoulder blades, separating your hands, not forcing, but you want to a nice open on the shoulder blades, yeah? So from there, we will push into the feet, we will lifting up, thighs, the belly's in, we go with the groins up, into that neck. So you want to feel the top of the shoulders and the back of the head as your support there. And try to spread a tiny bit more your arms there. Not forcing, yeah? You want to create more space to feel the middle of your spine between the shoulder blades, yeah? You want to feel those bones there on the floor. At the same time, we are working, obviously, on hips, yeah? And then relax, lower slowly to feel on your spine, yeah? Good. Now, we will practice the same hug that we did in hero pose. On the bridge, yeah? This time, maybe we can catch the shoulder blades, you will catch your upper arms, yeah? So we will go with our open arms again to the bridge, pushing into the feet, lifting thighs, lifting groins, position again, that you feel the top of the shoulders on the floor, your neck long, and the back of the head as a support, chin toward the chest. And spread your arms. Go slowly with the arms up. Try to move there the shoulder blades to, again, feel the bones between the shoulder blades, yes, or the spine. And try to catch your elbows or your upper arms, keeping the bridge, yeah? So you want to move there to feel the bones of your spine between your shoulder blades. Could be not comfortable, but we are creating a space there. And then relax, release, soften. Well done. We put the arms on the side, more on the side of your body now. We will bring the palms facing up. And you want to roll the shoulder before you do anything else, yeah? So when you roll the shoulders, we will do the opposite movement. The shoulder blades are getting more closer and you are lifting the chest, yeah? So when you go to the bridge, lifting thighs, groins, again, you feel the shoulder blades the top of the shoulders on the floor, chin toward the chest. And now with your arms, you try to push with the upper arms. So from the shoulder to the elbow, let's say, the upper arm push toward the floor. At the same time that you bring the chin toward the chest and you're lifting your groins. It's not catch the hands or push, it's grounding with your upper arms to create more space on the back of the neck. Ah, relax, relax, well done. And we bring the knees toward your belly and soften. Well done. Expand. Very nice. Now, we keep the thighs close to your belly, nice and open, lifting your feet. The knees are open and beside your body. Keep the head on the floor, chin toward the chest. We can catch the thighs, we can catch the calf, we can catch the feet. Don't go to take the toes if you're lifting the head. Yeah? You want all the weight of your body on your back there to help you to spread more. Yeah? So wherever is comfy. Rosalind, for sure, your baby did this position a lot. Yeah? Maybe he still does. Now, soften, and we will bring the knees toward one side, opening the side of your body here, your arms nice and comfy. You can place a pillow between your knees or beneath your leg. Spread and relax. Soften. Now, bring back the visualization of the roots absorbing energy from the planet, flowing through your body, overflowing your body, filling your cocoon. Yes, so you are receiving now a beautiful, nourishing, recharging energy that will be so much that you can have, you have to put it on the cocoon to have it as a reserve there, okay? For whenever you need it. And allow the same energy, when it's passing through your body, it's melting more and more the remaining tension. Yeah? As you move through the class, you notice what the spots are the ones that need more attention. So imagine that this energy goes focus on those spots and the energy is working for you like a massage, yeah? Releasing that pain. And then we move to the other side. Relax. Soften. Release, release, release. And now imagine that you receive a beautiful loving energy from the planet, yeah? Like an energy of unconditional love. Remember, that's the pink light. So imagine a beautiful pink light going up through your body, filling your cocoon. And imagine that this loving energy is also overflowing the cocoon and is filling your room and your whole house. And if you feel generous today, you can imagine that this energy is also overflowing your house and is bathing the whole neighborhood or the city or the world. Yeah, you decide how you feel today. Yeah, you don't have to. Yeah, first you have to reach out yourself to be able to give to others, right? And coming back to the center. And we go to Shavasana, nice and flat, comfy, open legs, open arms. If you notice lower back pain when you are stretching, you put a pillow or the blanket beneath your knees, yeah? And nice and comfy, put blankets, pillows, so we sit so I can lead you. Again, once you find your comfortable position there. Exhale. Again, visualize everything in place, see the roots, the planet offering energy and loving energy, your cocoon surrounding you. Imagine all this energy will also enhance and strengthen that cocoon as a beautiful filter. And then we will receive another flow of energy. Yeah? Imagine that I'm sending this extra energy from here. So imagine that energy will enter into your feet and will give you more relaxation, more peace, more comfort. Yeah. So allow yourself to be ready to receive this extra energy. And imagine this energy entering into your heels, the sole of your feet, your toes, the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your thighs, and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, all of your spine, your shoulder blades, your shoulders, your arms, your hands, your fingers, your wrists, going up through your elbows, up to your arms, to your shoulders, bathing all the top of your shoulders and the neck, the back of your neck, the crown of your head. Imagine part of the energy is going inside, yes, through the brain, and then down through the whole of your body, bathing all your organs, bones, muscles, cells. And then another part goes through your face, relaxing your face, your mouth, your jaw, and then your neck, your chest, your belly. And allow your body to surrender deeply into the loving support of the planet and go deeply inside now. And relax, relax, relax. Slowly, allow your awareness to start to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side, and bring your arms back. And lengthen and stretch. And from there we fall to one side, bending your knees. And we go to a sitting position. Crossing your legs. And breathing deeply. And now give a big thanks to yourselves for taking the time to come to class today. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you.